Hi everyone, I'm Lottie from Studio Combined and I'm going to be taking you through your half an hour bar burn workout today. All you need is a chair, so when you're ready, I want you to start facing your chair about a forearm distance away and you're going to take it down into a gentle squat and then squeeze stand up. So down into your squat and then lifting up. So with this move, I want you to keep the weight back into your heels. So every time you drive up, really press your heels in towards the floor as you lift up and make sure you're really squeezing those glutes every time you stand up. So you're not sort of standing up halfway and then dropping down. I want you to really think about getting that full range for me, really engaging those glutes at the top, squeezing and pushing your pelvis towards the back of that chair. Keep your shoulders relaxed. And if you want, you can place your hands onto your hips if that feels better. Otherwise, you've got the chair there for support. And the whole time, I want you to take that weight back into your heels. So make sure your knees aren't coming forward and get that weight back from you. Stick your butts back behind you. Shoulders stay down and back. Let's go for another five, and then we're going to add in a heel rise. You've got four. Squeeze those glutes for me for three. Keep core on. You've got two. On one, let's add in that heel rise. You're gonna take it down into your squat and then drive up, lifting both heels. Drop both heels and take it down into your squat and then lift up those heels. So by adding in the heel rise, we're just activating our calves now. So just adding a little bit more onto those legs. Squeeze those glutes every time you take it back into your heels. Make sure that you can wiggle your toes the whole time. It's just gonna make sure that your weight stays back and then lifting up. When you lift up onto your toes, just check that your ankles aren't rolling out. So your ankles are always pointing forward, not rolling out for me. So you want to protect those joints. Let's go for another five. Yeah, good everyone, four more. Three, keep those shoulders relaxed. Two. And on one, you're gonna take it all the way down. Little pulses here for me. So with your pulses, get that weight back into your heels. So give me a little wiggle with those toes, making sure that weight isn't coming forward. Keep squeezing those glutes. Every time you press up, drive up with those heels. Let's go for five, four, three, two, and one. Stand all the way up. From here, lift your right heel off the floor. Roll those shoulders. Think about staying nice and tall. When you're ready, take it down into your squat. Drive up. Take it down into your squat. Drive up. So again, your weight is staying back in your heel, and you're keeping that right heel lifted the whole time. Make sure that as you take it down, you're not coming forward. You're still taking that weight back, even though your right heel is lifted. Chair is there if you need it. Otherwise, hands can come to your hips. You're keeping your shoulders relaxed. Keep that chest nice and open. You've got another five like this. Four, get even lower if you can. Let's go three, squeeze those glutes for two. On one, take it all the way down. Let's pulse out. Eight, seven, six, get lower. Five, four, three, two, and last one. Drive all the way up. Lower your right heel, pick up your left. And when you're ready, take it down into your squat. Drive back up. Take it down, lift up. So every time you lift up, again, press that right heel in towards the floor for me. Push that floor away. Really activate that right butt cheek. Keep your shoulders down and back, chest stays open, and you've got that chair there if you need to. Otherwise, hands can stay on your hips. Really good, guys. Let's warm up those legs. Yeah, this is the warm up. Keep going. Let's go for another five. Squeeze those glutes. Let's go four, three. Core stays on for two. On one, take it all the way down, pulse it out. Let's go eight, seven, get even lower, six, five, four, three, two. This time you're gonna stay low. You're gonna lower your left heel, pick up your right, and then switch and switch. Get even lower if you can. Keep switching, keep that shoulders down and back, keep your chest open. Core stays lifted. Let's go eight, seven, six, five, four. You're nearly there, three, two, and last one. Stand all the way up. Give those legs a shake. Take a nice wide second position. So your toes are pointing out, heels are pointing in towards you, and you're still that forearm distance away from your chair. When you're ready, you're gonna take it down into a plié, and then drive up. Take it down into a plié, lift back up. So with your plié, I want you to keep your shoulders stacked over your hips the whole time. So what we try and avoid doing is as you plié, you bring your chest forward, you stick your butts back. I want you to think about scooping, sort of tucking that sit bone under. Keep your shoulders over your hips as you do these pliés. You should be spiraling your inner thighs back behind you. So try and get those knees back behind you. Really start activating those inner thigh muscles and our outer glutes. So good, everyone. Really press those heels again in towards the floor every time you want to lift up. Let's go for another five. You've got this. Go four, Three, keep squeezing. Let's go two. And on one, drop it all the way down. Give me eight pulses for eight, seven, six, five. Keep that core switched on. Four, three, two, one. Stand all the way up. This time you're gonna add in that heel rise. Lower your heels, take it down to your plie. Stand up. So heel rise, lower, plie, up. Heel rise, lower, plie, up. So again, with those heel rises, try not to lock out through your ankles. Ankles stay nice and soft. And you're still keeping those shoulders stacked over your hips. So no leaning forward for me. Try and lean back a little bit more. Yeah, you've got this, guys. Warm up those legs for me. Get those heart rates up. You've got another five. Four more. Squeeze those glutes. Let's go. Three. Two more. On one, you know what's coming. Take it all the way down for me. Eight pulses. Eight, seven, six. Keep tucking under. Five, four, three, two, one. Stand all the way up. Pick your right heel off the floor for me. You're taking it down, drive up. Take it down, drive up. If your right leg is starting to shake, I want you to keep going. Bear with me, you've got this. Feeling that right glute now working, feeling your right thigh and your left butt cheek, your supporting leg should be really switched on. So keep pressing that left heel in towards the floor. You've got another four. Three, keep that core switched on for two. And on one, drop it all the way down. Eight pulses, eight, seven, six. Try and spiral your knees back behind you for three, two, one. Stand all the way up. Lower your right heel, lift your left. We're going again. You take it down, drive up. So keep pressing that right heel in towards the floor for me, guys. Make sure that you're not starting to stick your butts out. Tuck under. So really try and flatten your lower back here. Keep going. You should be feeling inner thighs now working and outer glutes. Let's go for another five. Four, get even lower if you can. Let's go three. Drive up with that right heel for two. And on one, take it all the way down. Pulse it out for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and last one. Come all the way up. Give those legs a shake for me. We're not quite done on our legs. So when you're ready, you're gonna still be that forearm distance away from your chair. It's about to say bar, from your chair. And then we take a squat backwards, making sure that your knees are over your heels and your knees aren't over your toes. So really push your weight back behind you. Pick your right foot off the floor. Keep putting those toes in towards your shin. And when you're ready, you're gonna drive that heel back behind you. Bring that knee back in. So you're gonna drive back. Knee comes in. So with this move, everyone, I want you to think about your lower back. So you're keeping your lower back nice and straight and you're not arching. So you're not bringing your tummy forward towards the back of the chair. Think about tucking under again, like we were doing in those plies. So you're keeping that nice straight back and you're really having to activate that right butt cheek here to press that heel back. Keep your shoulders down and back so you're not rounding forward. So really lifting away from that chair. And you should be feeling this also in that left butt cheek. So if you're feeling in your left thigh, I want you to shift your weight backwards a little bit. So really making sure that your knee isn't coming over those toes, push your weight back behind you. Yeah, really good, guys. Squeezing in those glutes. You should be feeling this in right glute and in left glute. Try and get a little deeper onto that left leg for me. Let's go for five. You've got this. Four, three. Keep lifting up through core for two. And on one, hold it up. Eight pulses for me. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. On one, come back through to center. Take that leg out to the side, pull in. So out to the side and in. Check both hip bones are still pointing towards the back of the chair and you're not spiraling that right hip bone back behind you. I want you to keep pulling this right hip bone down. You're still nice and low on that left leg for me. Try not to hang on to the back of your chair for dear life. Try and keep nice and soft shoulders. You've got this. Let's go five, four, your left glute, your supporting leg should be burning up now. You've got two and on one, hold up, me little pulses up. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, on one. You're gonna step that leg back behind you, finding your upright lunge. You get a lunge down for me, and then you're gonna open up, coming into your second position. Turn back to face your chair, lunge down, twist into second. Come back to your chair, lunge, twist, second. So with this move, your lunge is working into that left glute still, so we're still working into that left glute, and your plie is working into your inner thighs again and those outer glutes. So you've done a lot of plies already, so remember keeping shoulders over your hips, try not to lean forward. Yeah, really good, everyone. With your lunges, make sure that both knees stay at that 90 degree angle. So you're keeping those front knees over your heel, not coming over your toes. Nearly there, I promise. Well, for this exercise, you've still got a whole other class to do. Keep those shoulders relaxed. Let's go four. Get those heart rates up. You've got three. Nice, everyone. Let's go two. Keep those shoulders down and back. On one, hold it in your plie. Pulse it out for eight, seven, six. Relax those shoulders. Five, four, three, two. Stay down on one. You're going to sweep that right arm overhead. Come back to your plie. Sweep and back to your plie. Try and get even lower on those legs for me. So you should be feeling your legs loading up now. Squeeze into that left oblique as you twist and plie. Let's go four. Nearly done. Three. Keep those shoulders relaxed for two. And last one. I want you to keep your arms swept overhead, but you're gonna stand all the way up. From here, you're gonna bring your right knee in towards your right elbow. So twist up and then lower down. Twist up and then lower. So working into that right oblique, keep your left leg nice and straight now. So you're squeezing into this oblique. So every time you bring your elbow in, I want you to think of that rib and hip connection shrinking. So you're really having to pull in and reach out. So pull in, reach out. Yeah, really good, everyone. Heart rate should be getting up now. Let's go for another eight, seven, nearly there, you've got six. Squeeze into that oblique, five, four, looking good, everyone. Let's go three, two, and last one. Come all the way up. Give your legs, arms, obliques a shake. You've got the other side to do. So I'm going to move my chair around. So moving my chair over here. And we're going to do the other leg. So when you're ready, I want you to stand that forearm distance away from your chair again. Take that squat backwards. So making sure that your knees are over your heels. Pick that left foot off me. Keep those toes pulled in. And when you're ready, you're going to drive back with that heel and then pull in. So drive back and in. Relax through those shoulders. Making sure that that weight stays back into that right heel. So you don't want to let that knee come forward. I want you to really think about sort of shifting that weight back. Stay nice and low on that right leg as you drive back with that left heel. So I want you to be squeezing this left butt cheek every time you press back rather than using your lower back. And I want you to stay nice and low on that right glute. So you're supporting glute. Keep shoulders down and back. Keep chest open. Keep thinking of tucking that sit bone under a little bit for me. Yeah, looking good, everyone. So you should be feeling this in both legs. Keep nice control here. And again, just check that this right knee isn't coming over your toes. So you're squeezing back for another five, four. Keep lifting up. Let's go three, two, on one. Hold back, little pulses back and back. We're squeezing. Keep squeezing into this left glute. Stay nice and long on that right leg. You've got five, four, three, two, on one, come back through to center, take it out to the side, and in. So remember last time we were trying to keep that hip bone down, make sure that your left hip bone is staying nice and low, so you're not lifting it up, keep it nice and low, keep it pointing towards that chair. I want your right leg to be really switched on now. Keep nice and low, you've got this. Let's go six, five, keep lifting up through your pelvic floors. Let's go four, three, two, on one, hold up, pulse up, little pulses here. Squeeze, 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 keep going into that left glute and feeling in that right glute. We're here for five, four, three, two, on one. Step that left leg back behind you, coming into your upright lunge. So you take it down into your lunge, spiral open, find that second position, and then twist back. So we lunge, open, plie, twist. So lunge, open, plie, and twist. So with your lunges again, you're trying to keep those knees at a 90 degree angle. And with your plies, I want you to keep your shoulders stacked over your hips the whole time and try and push your knees back behind you. You're really good, everyone. Really squeezing into those glutes for me. Looking good. Keep shoulders nice and relaxed. Let's go for another five. Nice, everyone. You've got four. Try and get a little lower in those lunges now. Let's go three, two more. Your heart rate should be up. Let's go one more for me and then hold it down into your plie for eight pulses, for eight, seven. Stack those shoulders over hips. You've got five, four, three, two. Stay low on one. Sweep that left arm towards your chair. Come back to your plie. Take it over to your chair. back to your plie. Try and get a little lower now into that plie for me. You should be feeling this in both legs. I know I definitely am. Keep those shoulders down and back. Keep that chest proud for me. Keep going. You've got another five like this. Get a little lower if you can. Let's go four. Squeeze, squeeze. Three. Work into those obliques. Let's go two. And on one, you're going to stand all the way up for me, keeping that left arm where it is. You're going to bring left elbow to meet left knee, step back out. Left elbow to left knee, step out. So we're working into that left oblique. So remember, as we bring the elbow to meet knee, I want you to shrink that rib and hip connection. Make it as small as possible, and then find that length. So you squeeze into it, and then extend. Squeeze, and then extend. Looking really good, everyone. Keep those shoulders relaxed. You've got this. So this is really working into our torso here, it's working into our waist muscle. But you should also be feeling this in your supporting leg, in the moving arm. It's pretty much a whole body workout. Let's go for another five. Four, you've got this, guys. You've got three. Keep going for another two. And last one. Oh, just give your arms and legs a shake. And when you're ready, I want you to twist your chair around. So you're gonna move this chair around so it's facing you. Make sure that your chair is sturdy. You're gonna grab the outside sort of sides of your chair. And I want you to find a nice sort of tabletop position. So you've got a nice flat back. If that means having a slight bend in your knees, please do. Just don't look out your knees for me. From here, I want you to extend that left leg back behind you. Roll your shoulder blades down about, take an inhale in. Exhale, you're gonna lift that left leg up, lower down, tap the floor. Lift up and lower. So you're keeping your shoulder blades down and back, so you're not letting your chest dip down. Think about lifting up. Imagine you've got two oranges underneath your armpits right now, so you're having to pull away from the chair. And I really want to keep that left leg nice and active. So point those toes to me and squeeze into that left glute every time you lift up. Make sure that you're not starting to let your tummy drop down towards the chair. I want you to think about really pulling up for me, squeezing into that left glute. You've got this. Keep going, guys. So keep pointing those toes. Let's activate that left leg. You've got another five, four, three. Looking good. You've got two. On one, hold up. Give me eight pulses. Let's go eight, seven. You've got this. Six, five, four, three, two. On one, you're going to paint a rainbow. So you're going to sweep that left leg over to the left and then take it over to the right. So take it over to the left, so nice control here, and then over to the right. So with your rainbows, it's not about how high you can get that leg. The important part is to keep that back nice and straight. Your hip bones don't move, so keep left hip bone, right hip pointing down towards that chair, and you're squeezing into that left glute. You've got this. Keep pressing into that chair, so your shoulder blades are down and back, pull belly to spine. Let's go five. Yeah, really good, guys. You've got four. Squeeze those glutes. Keep those hip bones stable. You've got three. Keep that leg nice and straight. You've got two. And on one, do one more for me, and then you're gonna step that left leg back behind you. Core stays switched on, and you're gonna lift your right knee in towards your chest. Step that right leg down, and then lift your left leg up, and then lower. So right leg comes in. Lower that right leg, left leg lifts. So right leg to chest, use your core, lower it down, left leg lifts. So this is working your abs as you bring that right knee in and then left glute to lift that left leg up. Keep pressing into that chair for me. Make sure your chest stays nice and open. No arching through your lower spines. Keep core switched on. You've got this, everyone. Let's work those abs. You've got eight. You've got seven. Keep pressing into your chair. Six. Looking good. You've got five. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Four more. Work those abs. Three. Let's go two, and last one. Give me one more for me, and then lower that leg down. Step your left leg in, and we're gonna do the other side. So finding that nice flat back to start with, soft knees, make sure that you're not locking out those knees. Lift your shoulder blades away from your ears. Step that right leg back behind you. Square off your hip bones, make sure your right hip bone hasn't crept up. And when you're ready, let's lift up, lower down. Lift up, and lower. So again, you're keeping that right leg nice and active. So keep it pointed the whole time. That's just gonna really activate that whole right leg for me. Shoulder blades stay down and back, chest stays open. So remember those oranges underneath your armpits, really lift up and away from them. Keep that core switched on so we're not arching through our lower spines. So you almost want to tuck your sit bone under a little bit so they're not lifting up and letting our lower backs arch. Think about zipping up here. Keep those elbows nice and soft and really squeeze into that right butt cheek every time you want to lift up. So squeeze your glutes when your foot's on the floor and keep squeezing as you lift and keep squeezing as you lower. So really activating that glute. Go for another 8. Looking good, guys. You've got 7, 6. If you're feeling this in your left leg, that is completely normal. It is your supporting leg, so you may be feeling it coming into that left butt cheek a little bit. Let's go for another 2. And on 1, you're gonna hold up, give me those 8 pulses for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ready for your rainbow. So take it over to the right. Sweep over to the left. Take it over to the right. And then over to the left. So imagine something really fragile is behind you and you're really having to lift up and over it rather than sort of just sweeping across. Think about lifting up and over whilst keeping your hip bones nice and stable, whilst keeping that back nice and straight. Lots to think about. Soft elbows, keep lifting up and away from that chair. Really good, everyone. You've got this. Let's go for another 5. Squeeze it into those glutes. You've got 4. Nice, guys. Let's go 3. Squeeze into that right leg. Let's go 2. And give me 1 more for me. And then you're going to step that right leg back behind you. When you're ready, core switched on. Bring that left knee into your chest. Step that left leg down as you lift that right leg up. Lower down. Squeeze, lift. Lower, lift. Up, squeeze, lift. Lower, lift. And down. So as you do this, guys, make sure that you've got nice soft elbows. Shoulder blades stay down, but you're working into the abs as you bring that left knee in towards your chest, and then you're working into that right butt cheek as you sweep that right leg back behind you. Keep squeezing those abs for me, guys. You've got this. Let's go for another 6. You've got 5. Work those abs for me. Think about lifting up through your pelvic floor the whole time. Give me 3 more. Elbows stay soft. 2, and give me 1 more for me, guys. 1 more, bring that left knee in and then step that right leg in. Just walk those legs back a little bit for me. Find a nice hamstring stretch, find a nice spine stretch and just hold this here for a breath. Big inhale in, every time you exhale, just release that stretch a little bit more. So find a deeper stretch. Do 1 more breath, inhale in. And then exhale, release. When you're ready, you're going to turn around and face away from your chair. So we're gonna do some triceps and then we're gonna finish on abs. So when you're ready, grabbing the same place that you were just grabbing with your glute exercise, so the side of your chair, and shuffle your bums towards the front of your chair. So you're just about to fall off, but don't fall off. So keeping your feet nice and stable, roll those shoulder blades down and back. You're now gonna take yourself off that chair. On your inhale, you're gonna sort of brush the front of the chair down your back, elbows go back behind you, exhale, push up. Inhale, lower, elbows back behind you. Exhale, push. So use your breath. Inhale, lower. Exhale, push. If you'd like to make this easier, just step your feet closer towards you. If you would like to make this harder, take your legs all the way out and you can do this with legs extended, or you can come sort of in the middle, whatever works for you. I'm gonna keep my feet underneath my knees for this. Just so I can talk to you without struggling. Keep those shoulders down and back for me. Keep those elbows pointing back behind you. Really working in those triceps. Remember, inhale lower, exhale up. Inhale lower, exhale up. You've got this. Make sure that that chair is still brushing down your back. Go for another 8. Keep that core switched on for me, guys. You've got 7. Work in those triceps. You've got 6. Keep going. Let's go 5. 4 more. Remember to breathe. Very important. Let's go 3, 2. On 1, you're going to drop halfway down. Give me 8 pulses. 8, 7. Try and pinch your elbows closer together for 4, 3, 2. And last one, come all the way up. Oh, so onto your chair for me. Just bring that right arm across your body. Make sure that right shoulder blade doesn't go with you. So pull that right shoulder blade back. Big inhale and take it overhead. Push that hand down your sort of upper back. Feeling that tricep stretch here. When you're ready, release. Bring that left arm over. Feel that stretch into your left tricep into your left upper back. Again, just make sure that your left shoulder hasn't rounded forward. And when you're ready, take that arm overhead, press that hand down, feel that nice tricep stretch. Nice, everyone. Big inhale in. And then exhale, release. So when you're ready, we're gonna get started on abs. So I want you to stand facing your chair and then you're gonna come all the way down onto the floor. So your legs are gonna come up onto your chair, so calves onto the chair, and just shuffle your bums towards the chair for me and then lying all the way down. If you've got a mat, obviously, feel free to put the mat down, or you can do this just on your floor. So hands are gonna come behind your head, interlace your fingers, thumbs running down the back of your neck. And I want you to find your neutral spine. So your pelvis is flat towards the ceiling into the floor, and you've got this curve underneath your lower back. Elbows wide on your inhale, exhale, curl up towards your knees. Make sure that you've still got that gap, and then inhale, lower down. Exhale, lift, inhale, lower. So I want you to really think about lifting up and away from the floor here. So you wanna try and get both shoulder blades off the mat without arching your lower spine and without tilting your pelvis towards your belly button. So you're keeping a nice flat pelvis, you're keeping that gap underneath your lower back, and you're curling up. So really tucking your chin in, lifting up, elbows staying wide. Starting to feel this coming into those abs for me. Yeah, you've got this, everyone. Work those abs for me, and then you've done a full body workout. When you're ready, we're gonna add on. So give me four more. Try and lift a little higher. Go for three. Two, you should still have that gap underneath your lower back on one. And then you're gonna curl up and lift your right knee in towards your chest. And then placing that leg back on the chair. Left leg comes towards chest, and then lower down. Exhale, curl. And then lower. Keep that gap underneath your lower back. So I really need you to focus on squeezing into those abs to pull yourself up, as opposed to using that curve in your spine. Elbows wide, try and get a little bit more height now. Let's go five. You've got four, so good everyone. Three, two more. On one, we're gonna add in a pulse. So you're gonna curl up, pulse once, and then curl back down. Curl up, pulse, and then curl down. With your pulses, I want you to think about sliding your ribs and your hips together, even smaller. So really working into those abs for me. Try and lift both shoulder blades off the mat a little bit higher now, elbows wide. You should be feeling this in those abs. Give me another six. Go for five, lift yourself a little bit higher. Every time you pulse, curl up a little higher for me. Three more. Looking good, let's go two. And last one, curling yourself all the way down. Take a big inhale, exhale, curl up towards your knees. Give me eight pulses, let's go eight, seven, six, five, four, nearly there, three, two, and last one, curl all the way down. Last little bit and then you're done. Big inhale and exhale, gonna bring your right armpit to left knee, twist and then curl down. Twist to the other knee and then curl down. So we're trying to get armpit to knee and not elbow. So really finding that twist here. Get a little bit more height if you can. You've got this. Let's go for another five. Then we're adding pulses. You've got four. Elbows wide. Three. Two. Get a little bit more height. One. Let's add those pulses. Curl up, pulse. Curl back down. Curl up, pulse. And then lower. So curling up, twist, 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 and then lower down. You've got this, let's work those obliques. Let's go for another six. Get a little bit more height for me if you can. You've got four, three, nearly there, guys. Let's go two, and last one. Curl all the way down. Oh, bring your knees in towards your chest. Roll from side to side for me. And I want you to rock yourself over, coming into a four-point kneeling position. Tuck those toes under for me. Just pike your hips up towards the ceiling. Just pedal out your feet. So dropping your heel down, lifting up, dropping your heel. And slowly walk your hands to your feet. Where I want you to roll yourself up. So coming through lower spine, into mid-spine, into upper spine. Big shoulder roll for me, guys. From here, you're gonna bring your left heel over that right thigh. Just sit down into a glute stretch. If you don't have the chair near you, just grab something to hold onto so you can really find that stretch. Big inhale and exhale, so I'm nice and tall. Right heel over left thigh, guys. Drop down into that stretch, feeling a nice glute stretch. Try to get a little lower if you can. Big breath in, inhale in. Exhale, side all the way up. Another big shoulder roll for me. Bring both hands up to the ceiling. Hunch your shoulders. Relax your shoulders, relax your arms, and you are done for your barre burn this morning. Thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you next time. Well done, everyone.